Hello everyone, welcome to week two of the Christmas Eve Wishes Cal. This week we're going to be working on the snowflakes and we're going to be working from a chart. I'll tell you more about that later. But before we begin, I just wanted to show you a close-up of the snowflakes. You can see that there are little flecks of white yarn showing where it's been carried along the rows. This is completely normal. This is what happens in tapestry crochet. There's absolutely nothing you can do about it. It's just how tapestry crochet looks. And I don't think it spoils the appearance of the finished blanket at all. So if when you're working, you see these little flecks of white yarn, don't worry, completely normal, and it will look lovely when it's finished. Okay, let's get started. This week we're going to be working the snowflakes from a chart, and don't worry if you've never used a chart before. They're very simple once you know how all the numbers work. I've zoomed in a bit so you can see it more clearly, and I'm going to explain those to you now. So each square in the chart, each individual square represents one double crochet stitch, that's UK, or US single crochet stitch. And the numbers along the bottom are the stitch numbers. So here they're numbered 1 to 30. And the numbers going up the sides are the row numbers. And we have 25 rows. So we've got 1 to 25 here and 2 to 24 here. And we are going to start working this first stitch that's labelled 1, 1. And we're going to work along the chart from right to left. Now there are 30 stitches in this chart and this represents one pattern repeat. So we are going to repeat this pattern 5 times across the width of the blanket. So 5 times 30 stitches will give you your 150 stitches for the complete width of the blanket. So the first row we're going to work, we're going to start here on the chart and we're going to work 30 stitches, so 30 red double crochet stitches or US single crochet stitches, and then we're going to repeat that 4 more times until we've worked 150 stitches in total. So this is row 1 of the chart, which is row 16 of the blanket overall, and we're just carrying on from where we left off last week. So I said don't fasten off because we're going to carry on, and we're going to change colour in that very last pull through of the last half treble crochet or US half double crochet that we made in row 15. And I've changed to a 4.5mm hook for this. I used a 4mm hook for this section of my blanket. And I've changed to a larger hook because double crochet stitches, US single crochet stitches, especially with colour changes, tend to be a bit tighter than other stitches. And this can make the edge of your blanket pull in. You get a curve because they're tighter. So to help with this, go up half a hook size. And if you've used a different size hook than I did for this bottom section, whatever size hook you used, I recommend going up half a size for this next section. So I'm going to take my red, make a loop exactly as we did before, change to red in that last pull through, chain one because this is a double crochet stitch row or US single crochet stitch row, going to turn my work and then remember that the chain one does not count as a stitch, so my first stitch is going to go into this very first stitch of the row. And then I'm going to make one double crochet stitch in each stitch of the row. And then when you get to the end, you need to make sure that you've got 150 stitches. It's very important because the rest of the the chart won't work if you don't start with 150 stitches. So I've worked my first row of 150 stitches. So now I'm going to start row two. So row two is exactly the same as row one. We've got 30 red stitches in the chart, and I'm going to work 5 repeats. So I'm going to work 150 red stitches along the row. Row three now, and row three has color changes. So we've got red and white stitches. And I'm going to show you a little tip that will help you to keep track of your rows. So I've got a couple of strips of just printer paper, regular printer paper, and I've folded the ends so that I can wrap them round the sides of my printout. So I'm just going to tuck those ends underneath so my strip is wrapped around the printout, and just slide that up to the bottom of the row that I want to work on. So I'm sliding that up to the bottom of row three. A couple of paper clips just to hold that piece of paper in place. And then I'm going to do the same above. So I'm just wrapping my piece of printer paper around, and I'm going to slide it down to the top of row three. Paper clips. So now I've got my row three in a little window. So all I can see is row three. I know what row I'm working on, and it will make it much easier to count and keep track of where you are. And also, if you stop working and go away and come back to it later, you'll always know what row you were on. So row three, we're going to work 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 red double crochet, US single crochet, followed by one white, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 red double crochet, followed by one white, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 red double crochet, and we're going to repeat this 5 times across the width of the blanket. So I'm all set up to start working row three. I've got my high-tech row keeping device all set up. I know you can buy gadgets for these, but I always like to use things I've got lying around the house. And here's one more tip that will help you keep track of the pattern repeats. So on my blanket, I've just popped stitch markers every 30 stitches, and you can absolutely use the plastic ones if you want to, but I quite like just using little loops of scrap yarn. So that's 30 stitches from the end, place a marker, count another 30 stitches and place a marker, and do that all the way along, every 30 stitches, marking the repeats on the chart. And then you only have to concentrate on one section of the chart at a time. So I've started row three in the usual way. I've chained one, turned, and I've made 7 of my 10 red double crochet stitches that the chart says I need to make. But we've got a colour change coming up, and the colour change happens in exactly the same way as you did for the cream bobbles. We always make the colour change in the stitch before we need to use the new colour. So I've got 7 of my 10 red stitches, so 8, 9, 10. So in the 10th stitch, we're going to make the colour change. So rather than finishing the stitch with the red yarn, I'm going to put the red yarn away from me, and I'm going to bring in the cream yarn, fold the end over, and pull through a loop of cream to change to cream. going to put the tail out of the way, and I'm going to bring the ball of cream yarn towards me, and I'm going to keep the cream yarn well away from the red yarn. And as long as they're always separated and you always pick up the cream yarn from the front and keep the red yarn to the back, they won't twist together. So I'm going to make my one cream stitch, and this is probably the trickiest stitch in the whole blanket because we're only making one stitch, so we have to change back to red before we complete the stitch. So I'm going to pop my hook in, pull up a loop of cream, and that's trapping that red yarn inside the stitch. And then we have to change back to red. So I'm going to bring the cream to the front, change back to red, and there is my one cream stitch, and I've changed back to red to make my 9 red stitches. So I'm going to pop my hook in, red stitch, and I'm working over the cream yarn and trapping that cream yarn inside the stitch. So that's 2. Three, four, five, six. So that's 7, 8, 9. So that's my last red stitch. So I've got another colour change, but before I do that, I'm just going to turn it over and show you the back. And your cream yarn should be sitting inside the red stitches. If you've got any little loops sticking out here, just give the cream yarn a gentle pull just to pull them back inside the red stitches. But don't pull too hard, because if you do, your stitches are going to bunch together, and that's going to make the edge of your blanket pull in, and you won't have a nice neat straight edge. So gentle pull, and ideally your cream yarn should just be laying across the top of the stitches, hidden inside and not pulled tight. So I've got my colour change. So red yarn away from me so it doesn't get twisted. Change to cream, and then I'm going to start my cream stitch, trapping the red yarn inside, but we're only making one stitch, so we have to change straight back to the red. So the cream yarn comes to the front and we change to red, and that's our one stitch in cream, and we've changed back to red to carry on. So now I'm going to finish the pattern repeat, and that's with 9 red stitches. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. And I've reached my marker, so I'm just going to take that out, make my last stitch, and then just replace my marker in that stitch so it's ready for the next row. And by using stitch markers, you'll always be able to keep track of your pattern repeats. And you can check that you've made the right number of stitches before moving on. So if you've made a mistake, you'll only ever have to pull back 30 stitches at most to correct that mistake, rather than getting to the end of a row and then finding that you've missed a stitch somewhere. So highly recommend using stitch markers, and check each pattern repeat before you move on to the next one. So I'm going to finish this row by repeating the pattern exactly the same 4 more times across the width of my blanket. So now I'm at the start of row 4. I'm working from left to right, and for the rest of the chart it's always the same. You're either working from left to right or you're working from right to left, and you're just going to count the number of stitches and work the number of stitches required by the chart. So for row 4, we're going to make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 red double crochet stitches, 2 white, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 red, followed by 2 white, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 red stitches. We're going to repeat that 5 times across the width of the blanket. So I'm at the end of row 3, about to start row 4. So I'm going to chain 1. I'm going to turn my work, and I'm going to work my first stitch over the cream yarn. So I'm going to bring the cream yarn behind, work my first stitch trapping that cream yarn, and then just give the cream yarn a little gentle pull just to nestle it against the side of the blanket. Don't pull too hard so you distort this edge. It's just so it's not a big loop sticking out. And then I'm going to bring the cream yarn back to the front so it doesn't get tangled up. Always keep the cream yarn towards you. And then I'm going to work the rest of my red stitches. So I need 9 altogether before I colour change. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I don't finish that last stitch because it's a colour change. So my red yarn away from me, change to cream, and then I'm going to work my 2 cream stitches. So that's 1, and then the second one is a colour change again, so I'm going to work 1, don't finish that stitch with the cream, put the cream to the front, change to the red, and now I work my red stitches. And that's the 7th stitch. So this is a colour change again. So red yarn away from you. Pick up the cream. And that's 1. That's my 2nd stitch. So now it's a colour change. Cream yarn towards you. Pick up the red. And then finish the repeat with the red stitches. And that's 10. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And I've reached my marker, so I can pull that out and pop it back in this stitch so it's ready for the next row. And that's my first repeat complete. So I've completed row 4 and I've got my 2 rows of double crochet, US single crochet in red, and then I've got my 2 rows with colour changes, and you can see that the points of the stars are starting to emerge. And I've got this repeated 5 times, 5 pattern repeats across the width of my blanket, and that's going to make 5 stars in total. So now you need to keep working through the chart row by row in exactly the same way. When you get to row 13, you'll see that it's worked in green. So at the end of row 12, you can cut cream and change to green in row 13. And then row 14 goes back to cream. So at the end of row 13, you can cut the green, change back to cream, and work the rest of the chart. And anywhere throughout the blanket where something is worked from a chart, so that's the gingerbread men, the Santa hats, and then repeating the snowflakes at the end, the charts will always be worked using exactly the same method and exactly the same colour changes. And the pattern will tell you which yarn to keep towards you and which yarn to keep away from you to make sure that the colours don't get tangled. So here are my 25 rows of the chart completed, making up the snowflake pattern. And these are rows 16 to 40 of the blanket. So when you finish this chart section, the pattern goes back to the regular row numbering, and you will need to switch back to your 4mm hook, or the same size you were using before the chart section. So we have rows 41, 42 and 43, making a candy cane stripe, and that's worked in exactly the same way as before. And then row 44 is green, and that's UK treble crochet, US double crochet. And then rows 45 and 46 are treble crochet, US double crochet in cream. And again, these are worked in exactly the same way as we did before. So if you need a little reminder, you can just have a look at the week 1 video and I'll link it below for you. So that's week 2 complete. And from now on, the whole blanket is made up of tapestry crochet, candy cane stripes, treble crochet stripes, and bobble stripes. And that means that you've learned all the techniques you need to complete the rest of the blanket. I'd really recommend having a read of the pattern, because I do give lots of extra tips in there for getting really good results, and the pictures will help you as well if you're not too familiar with reading patterns. And if you have any other questions, please ask, and I'll be happy to help in any way I can.